Sometimes you may need to programmatically set the value for a CSS custom property while building components in Angular. I personally run into situations occasionally where I need to use a custom property that needs to be set with a dynamic value. Like a bar chart, for example, where the items in the chart are based off of dynamic data. Well, in this video, we're going to look at three different ways to set custom properties programmatically. We'll use basic style binding, then we'll use the RenderToSetStyle method, and after that, we'll use host element binding. Okay, let's look at an example using simple style binding first. Here we have a chart component for displaying sales numbers by year. Right now, we have a for loop iterating over a list of sales per year data. For each year, we have a row of data, but there's a problem, huh? The bar for each year is the same height, even though the data is different. Well, this is what we're going to fix. Now, to make things easier, we're using the open source data visualization library, Charts CSS. So we don't need to worry about adding our own styles for the chart. This library uses HTML tables and provides several classes to style the chart as needed. But it's our job to provide our own custom data. And when we provide our data, we also need to supply the height for each bar in the chart using a size custom property. This custom property needs to be set as a decimal value. And we'll need to set it programmatically with a JavaScript math equation. So one way to do this is use simple style binding on the table cell for our bar. Let's add square brackets to bind to the style attribute. Then we add a dot, followed by the size custom property. Then we just need to provide our math equation to create our decimal value. This equation will take the item total and divide it by the max sales amount, which is the top value for our bar chart. In this case, it's set to 1,000. Okay, that should be all we need. So let's save and see how it looks. There, that's better. Now we have the proper heights for each of the bars in the chart. Another way we can programmatically bind custom properties in Angular is to use the RenderTo class setStyle method along with the DashCase flag. For this, we'll instead need to switch over to a chart item component for each of the items in the list. Now I've already created a component for this, so I'll need to first switch over and import it. Okay, now I can switch back to the template and remove the TH and TD since these are now going to be included in the template for our item component. This item component uses an attribute for its selector. So let's add this attribute to our table row. Okay, now this component has two required inputs. One for our max sales count, which we can bind to our max sales count property. And another for our item, which we can bind to our item from the for loop. Now if we save, we'll see our bars are not getting the right height style again. This is because we now need to set the custom property within our item component. So let's switch over to the code for this component and set this custom property with the renderer. The first thing we need to do is get a handle to the HTML element that we want to add the style to. So let's create a protected field called bar. This element is considered to be within the view for our component, so let's use a viewchild signal query typed as an element ref. And then we'll look for a reference variable with the name bar. Okay, now let's switch to the template and add this reference variable. There. Okay, now let's switch back to the TS. Okay, now we need to add a constructor. In the constructor, we need to inject in the renderer2 class. So let's add a field named renderer. And then let's add the renderer2 class. Okay, now we can use the renderer to add this custom property style. We will need to wait until we have access to the bar view child. So we'll use an effect for this. Then within this effect, let's use the renderer. We'll use the setStyle method. The first parameter for this function needs to be the element to add the style to. So let's add our bar view child and then access its native element. Then for the second parameter, we need to provide the style we're going to set as a string. So in this case, it'll be our size custom property. For the third parameter, we need to provide the value for this style. This will be our math equation again. So the item total divided by the max sales count. Okay, now we're almost there. Since we're adding a custom property, we need to provide a special flag to the setStyle method as the fourth parameter. We need to use the RendererStyleFlags.DashCase to access the dashCase flag value. Now, this is only needed because we're setting a custom property which starts with dashes. If we were binding to a known style property like color, height, width, or something along those lines, we wouldn't need this flag. Okay, that should do it. Now let's save again and see how we did. Nice. Now we have the correct styles again. So there's another possibility for programmatically setting custom properties. So if style binding doesn't work for you, maybe you can use the renderer. Now for this example, we have another possibility too. Since CSS custom properties cascade, we can actually bind it on our component host element, and then this should provide the proper value to the chart CSS library. To do this, let's first remove all of the stuff we added for the renderer concept. We can also remove the view child. Then we need to remove all the unused imports. And we can remove the template reference variable too. Okay, now to bind to the host element, let's add the host object. From here, it'll look a lot like the first style binding example. Let's add square brackets and then bind to the style attribute. Then we need to add a dot and then our size custom property. Okay, now we just need to set it using our math equation again. So we'll divide the item total by the max sales count again. Okay, that's it. So let's save and see how it looks. Nice. It looks like it's supposed to. So that means our style is getting added properly and then cascading down just like it needs to. Okay, so this isn't necessarily something that you'll need very often, but now at least you know how to programmatically set custom properties if and when you need to. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, check out my channel for more videos about various topics and features within Angular. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.